Hello everyone, dear friends. Today's review is dedicated to a device that, in my opinion, should be in every smart apartment, house, office, garage, and warehouse, a smart smoke detector with a built-in siren. I'm emphasizing the siren specifically, at the moment of smoke. Not only the smart part with push notifications and the ability to launch automation is important, but also an autonomous loud signal that immediately draws attention even where there is no internet and no smart home at all. In other words, the detector can be used as a standalone alert. There are many models of such detectors. In this video we'll break down one of them. I deliberately chose the Wi-Fi version rather than Zigbee. In my setup it's enough to provide backup power for the router and the internet, and the combination of autonomous detector plus Wi-Fi router with UPS plus network access gives stable remote notifications. With Zigbee, I would also have to duplicate power for the gateway, which complicates and increases the cost of the system. We'll go through the whole path: unboxing, initial setup, adding it to Tuya/Smart Life, what notifications arrive and how to configure simple automation scenarios. We'll separately look at how this detector behaves in the home assistant ecosystem. I will also run practical tests, disassemble the device, and share my conclusions. Specifications. Type: photoelectric smoke detector, 360 degree circular air intake. Connectivity and app: Wi-Fi, Tuya/Smart Life app, push notifications, event log, device sharing, simple scenarios. Power: 9V, 6LR61 battery, not included. The charge level is displayed in the app. Low battery threshold when less than 7 volts. Static current: less than 10 microamps. Current in alarm: less than 100 milliamps. Signaling and indication: built-in siren, stated at more than 80 decibels, red LED. Test/silence button. Operating ranges: temperature from 0 to plus 50 degrees Celsius, humidity up to 95%. Dimensions and mounting: diameter 107 mm, height 48 mm, ceiling mounting on a rotating base. It comes in a simple cardboard box without any markings. Inside are the detector itself and a paper manual. A 9V battery is not included. The manual lists the main parameters: power from a 9V, the siren volume level, operating temperature and humidity ranges, decoding of the LED indication and sound signals for different modes, test, alarm, low battery, as well as the correct ceiling mounting diagram with the mounting base and a step-by-step check after installation. Let's move on to the detector itself. The housing is fairly sizable, about 107 mm across and 48 mm high. On top you can see the acoustic grille. This is where the built-in siren with a stated loudness of 80 decibels is installed. Next to it is a combined button with an indicator LED. The button does three things: a short press silences an alarm, holding it for about 2 seconds starts a test signal, siren plus flashing LED and sending a test notification to the app. Holding it for longer than 5 seconds switches the device to Wi-Fi pairing mode. Different states are indicated by light and sound. In normal mode the LED blinks once every 60 seconds with no sound. In test mode the LED flashes rapidly and short beeps sound. When smoke is detected the LED flashes rapidly and a series of alarm signals follows. In a silenced alarm the LED continues to flash rapidly while the siren is muted. With a low battery the LED blinks once a minute and a single beep sounds once a minute. After successful Wi-Fi connection the indicator lights steadily for about 10 seconds without sound. In Wi-Fi setup mode the LED blinks at about twice per second and a short sound is played. Along the perimeter of the housing are air intake grills for 360-degree air sampling. The lower part is the mounting base. It comes off with a light twist, has two holes for self-tapping screws. You can also use good double-sided tape if the surface is flat and clean. Under the back cover is the compartment for a 6LR61 battery with a metal retaining clip that secures the cell and prevents it from falling out. Let's disassemble the detector and see what's inside. I remove the back cover and carefully unclip the central part. It's held by three plastic latches. On the inside of the front cover is the siren's piezoelectric transducer, a round metal diaphragm with wires, responsible for the loud alarm signal. The main electronics are on the middle board. The most noticeable unit is the black cylindrical labyrinth of the photoelectric chamber. Inside, set at an angle, are an infrared LED and a photodetector that register light scattering by smoke particles. Nearby is the tactile test/silence button and a transparent indicator LED that shows the operating modes. On the right of the board is the Tuya TYWE3S Wi-Fi module with a printed antenna. This is the brain of the app connection, the part that enables adding to Tuya/Smart Life and sending notifications. A separate low-power controller monitors the sensor and power, and the Wi-Fi module wakes only on an event, hence the very small current in standby mode. In the power section you can see proper decoupling, several electrolytics, including 100 microfarad 16 volts and 470 microfarad 6.3 volts, and regulation down to 3.3 volts for the logic. There's a siren driver that drives the piezo transducer during an alarm. The contact area for the 6LR61 battery with a metal retaining clip keeps the cell from rattling or falling out under vibration. Overall, the layout is neat. The smoke sensor is in a closed black compartment without stray light, the sound transducer is placed in the cover, and the Wi-Fi module is at the edge of the board for better reception. Let's connect the detector to the Tuya Smart ecosystem. I install a 9V battery and switch the device to pairing mode. I hold the button on the housing for about 5 seconds until the indicator starts flashing red rapidly. I open Tuya Smart or Smart Life, tap the plus in the upper right corner, and select adding a device. Usually, in a few seconds the detector is found automatically. If not, I select any device with Wi-Fi. If you have Zigbee, then select any Zigbee device. I confirm the 2.4 GHz network password and start adding. After a successful connection, the indicator lights continuously for about 10 seconds. You can set the detector's name and room. On the app's main screen, the device tile shows the time of the last activation, whether it was a real smoke alarm or a button test. As soon as you enter the plugin, the notification counter on the tile resets. Inside the plugin, in normal mode, you see the status, no smoke alarms, on a dark background. When an alarm occurs, a pop-up notification arrives that doesn't disappear until you open it, and an event card appears in the alarm section. From there you can go to the device, and if there are cameras in the same ecosystem, open an image right away. The detector tile's icon and label change to smoke alarm. Below in the plugin there's an indicator of smoke concentration, a numerical value on the manufacturer's scale. Below is a line with the date and time of the last event, and in the upper left corner, the battery charge percentage. The click for more button opens the history. You can see when smoke was detected and when the alarm was cleared. The settings provide toggles for counting the test alarm, the actual smoke alarm, and the low battery alert. Silent mode is off by default, and you can enable it. In general parameters you have rename, device information, shared access, and update check. At the time of recording there were no updates, module version 1.1.1, MCU version 1.0.0. Now let's see what the device can do in terms of automation. Since this is a detector, let's consider the possibilities in the if automations where the detector will act as a trigger for other devices. What can be used as triggers? Smoke detection state, a discrete smoke detection state. Smoke alarm, alarm recorded. Smoke alarm release, alarm cleared. Detected smoke is the numeric smoke level, in the app, PPM. Available conditions, less than, equal to, greater than, within range, outside range plus a value slider. Application, you can set a threshold, for example, greater than 5 ppm, instead of or in addition to the smoke alarm event. Battery level state is a categorical battery status, low, medium, high. Battery level, the battery charge percentage. The same conditions as for detected smoke, less than, equal to, greater than, within or outside range, plus a percentage slider. Convenient for a trigger like less than 20%. Silence, the siren mute status. Open mute, silent, alarm is enabled, siren off. OFF is the normal mode. A couple of practical, if-then, scenarios, based on these triggers. If smoke alarm, then turn on the light in the hallway or bedroom, start recording on a Tuya camera, send a notification. If smoke alarm release, then turn off the emergency lighting or unlock the power supply. If battery level is less than 20% or battery level state equals low, then send a notification. If silence equals open mute, then send yourself a reminder to check the premises and return the detector to normal mode. If detected smoke is greater than the set threshold, then additionally switch on an exhaust fan or open a motorized window, if compatible devices are available. Now let's look at the automation possibilities in the then block, where the detector acts as the executor. This is simple, only one action is available: toggle the silent mode, silence open or mute. You can turn it on and off with a scenario to muffle the siren during testing or after confirming a false alarm. There are no other actions in Tuya for this device, for example, play the siren on command. To be honest, I myself plan to use the built-in siren in common scenarios, but apparently the manufacturer deliberately removed such an option. The detector is a critical component, and its siren should be triggered only by smoke or by a manual test, without external starts. The logic is clear and, overall, I agree with it. If you need a controllable siren for your automations, get a separate Tuya siren and link it to the detector's events, while leaving the detector itself autonomous. If it once fails to shout, the trouble could be real. Let's test what the device can do in the Home Assistant smart home ecosystem. We'll check the integration via the Tuya cloud server. We go to our integrations and restart our Tuya integration. After that, we go to devices and find our detector. Here is smart Wi-Fi smoke detector. Here we see that our sensor is currently clear. If there is smoke, the status will be changed. Diagnostic information. Battery 69 and 0. Battery state, low is shown for some reason. And smoke amount 1.4, that is, 1.4 ppm. History is kept, and for the sensor as well, history is kept. Logbook is present. We can use automations, scenes, and scripts. We can add our sensor and diagnostic information to the dashboard. This is a Wi-Fi device. Right now it is working through the Tuya integration, which requires the internet. The detector is fully supported by the Home Assistant server. Let's run a test of the detector. But before that, I'll explain how to mount it correctly. I remove the detector from the base with a light twist and try out the spot. It's best to place it in the center of the room or 30 to 50 centimeters from a wall, farther from light sources, no closer than 50 centimeters to them, as well as from drafts, air conditioner, vent grill, and fan. Keep at least 1.5 meters away. Exclude the kitchen directly above the stove, the bathroom, and damp areas right away. Operating temperature is from 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. If there is a cabinet or mezzanine under the ceiling, step back at least 60 centimeters from the edge. Mark two holes, about 78 millimeters between them, drill, insert anchors, and screw on the mounting plate. I align the housing with the base and turn it until a characteristic click. That's it, the detector is in place. Then I hold the button for about 5 seconds to enable pairing mode. If you really don't want to drill, you can use quality acrylic double-sided tape, but for permanent installation screws are more reliable. Install it once, and forget it. We'll run a self-test. Press the test button for 2 seconds, and, as you can hear, the siren is triggered, the LED indicator starts flashing rapidly. Press the test button again to turn the siren off. A notification immediately arrived on the smartphone, and quite quickly. The test passed successfully. Now let's simulate smoke. To do this, I will light and extinguish a piece of paper, and I will hold the detector above it. We light it. We extinguish it. The smoke rises upward, but its concentration is not sufficient yet. We wait. Now there's a trigger. The siren is loudly sounding, the LED indicator is flashing, and a push notification arrived on the smartphone. This detector will not respond to open flame, it is not temperature based, but to smoke. When the laser in the sensor sees smoke, there will be an alarm. Therefore, it should not be placed directly above the kitchen stove, as there may be false alarms. Placement examples: a studio or one-room apartment. I install one in the main room, but step back 3 meters from the kitchen. The second, by the entrance in the hallway. In the kitchen itself, a heat detector is better, not a smoke detector. An apartment with 2 or 3 rooms, one in each bedroom plus one in the corridor by the bedrooms, another one in the living room. In the kitchen again, either a heat detector or a smoke detector with a large offset from the stove. A two-story house, on each floor, in the hall or by the staircase, and inside all bedrooms. I do not install a smoke detector in the basement or garage. A heat detector is more appropriate there, and a separate CO detector if there's a car. This is a simple and straightforward household smoke detector with a built-in siren and integration with Tuya/SmartLife that covers the main task to give a loud on-site alert and immediately send a notification to the phone. Installation and connection don't require any fuss. Mounted on the ceiling, insert a krona, hold the button for pairing, and everything's ready. In operation, I liked that the siren really attracts attention. The status indication is readable without a manual. The app has an event history and basic, if, automations. You can turn on a light, send a message, start recording on a camera, and on release, neatly return everything back. In terms of reliability for remote notifications, Wi-Fi is appropriate here if the router and internet are powered by a UPS. At the same time, the local siren remains autonomous and will trigger even without a network. This is an important point. The limitations are expected. As an executor, the detector can only enable silent mode. You cannot sound the siren remotely via scenarios, and that's logical so that the critical function doesn't depend on external conditions. Power from a 9-volt battery is not a record for autonomy, but the app has an indicator and a low charge warning, so keeping a spare battery is normal practice. In terms of placement, it hasn't become demanding. Don't place it right next to the stove and in drafts. Everything else is classic, on the ceiling and closer to the center. What to keep in mind before buying? This detector is not a replacement for a certified fire system, so we treat it as an additional layer of safety in an apartment or house. The Wi-Fi protocol is suitable for those who want to quickly add smoke monitoring with loud local alerting and push notifications to a smartphone, and also link the event to other Tuya devices. If you already have Zigbee deployed and the gateway is powered, feel free to look at a Zigbee analog, but for a quick start, the Wi-Fi version is the most trouble-free. Overall, the device does exactly what is stated. It installs quickly, warns loudly, sends notifications, and fits into a smart home without unnecessary magic, and that's exactly what you need from it. You will find all product links in the description under the video. There is also a link to the Telegram group, where you will find not only new products for the smart home system, but also coupons, promotions, and other communication, and answers to questions. There are also links to the smart home forum, where all topics are divided into sections for more convenient communication and information search. There are also links to the social networks Facebook and X. Please don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss other interesting videos about smart and not so smart home systems. All the best to everyone, peaceful skies, and kindness. Bye-bye.